The Ebola outbreak in Africa has held the attention of world officials for months. But what is Ebola? Why are so many worried? Is it something we all should be concerned about? Ebola virus disease, or Ebola hemorrhagic fever, is caused by a family of diseases shown here, of which the most well-known was once called the Zaire virus. Now, it is simply known as the Ebola virus. The virus can be found in a number of bat species, though the bats themselves do not show signs of the disease. They merely spread the virus from one bat population to another. Ebola does not yet infect humans at this stage in the life cycle. Though it's possible for humans to be exposed to Ebola virus directly from bats, this doesn't seem to be a regular method of exposure. A more likely scenario might involve intermediate animals like the duiker, a small deer-like animal that's hunted for food, or primates that are exposed to the virus from bats they encounter living in the jungle. Once these other animals become infected, any direct human contact with them at this point allows for the virus to be transferred into a human. When humans come into contact with carcasses of infected animals and become infected themselves, the virus becomes more easily transmitted to others. It should be noted that direct physical contact is necessary for infection. This disease is not spread in an airborne manner, like influenza. At this stage, patients who are infected can spread it to others around them. Family members living in the same house as infected individuals are at extreme risk, as are the hospital workers who eventually treat the patient. Medical waste generated by caring for victims must be properly disposed of. Even after death, the remains of victims are contagious. Unless great care is taken during funeral arrangements, the virus can spread to more and more people, causing epidemics. At this time, there is no cure for the Ebola infection or even a vaccine. Even effective experimental drugs are limited and hard to get. However, common preventative measures can limit the spread of the disease. Careful precautions around infected individuals are crucial, and many governments have quarantined affected areas or restricted travel. The only way to cure Ebola virus disease is to prevent exposure in the first place.